Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Sound one two. father and your heart recognize.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Very sad to be here. I saw the new heaven and the new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the whole city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with them, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them, and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain. For the former things are passed away." And he that sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new." And he said unto me, "Write, for these words are true and faithful." And he said unto me, "It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is a thirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son." For if you believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, hallowed be your name. We bow at this time. pay obeisance to you, Lord. We thank you, for you have been so very good to us. We thank you for life, we thank you for strength, we thank you for health, we thank you that we, O God, can gather here today to celebrate with the family of our sister. We thank you for the life that she has lived. We thank you, Lord, that she is yours. And so we are grateful. For we believe, O God, that she is with you. And though we say it quite flippantly, in a better place, we know that once she's with you, that she is indeed in the best place that she should be on campus. We pray even now as we commit this service into your hands that you, O God, will be well pleased. We pray, Lord, that your presence will be here with us. We need you, O God. And so we commit everything into your hands right now. In Jesus' name. Amen. Yes.
Well, the prayer has gone, and him and the Lord has gone, and the Reverend Stuart Dunham, the Tribune, the Devon Post Scripture Reading, etc. So, there's a lecture on a right, that you do to your reading and tributes. So at this time, I invite what would be lead us in the day. But the rule is for
given knowledge understanding and experience, by definition, of the nature and path of disease, I can speak truthfully within context of what understood during those times in which I had interaction with Sister Douglas. Maybe subject to some percentage of doubt, I think I'm the person who baptized her. When I was pastoring here in the late 70s and up to the middle 80s, my knowledge served me well with the power of God. Living and coming back before she came from my home with her mother. A house which was close to the then famous tower, a dance hall. Those of you who are of my generation would recall very well the famous tower. I recall at the school fair, there was a newly introduced dance entitled Disappointing. It was quite an intriguing and fascinating piece of art. If all of us, as boys and girls, enjoy the sound of the music. As Sister Douglas came to my home, thereafter, when I became somewhat close in relation as a neighbor, one house away from where I was living with my mother, I found her to have been quite a fairly well-spoken person, no-nonsense person, say what she had to, without any kind of a thereafter enemies. She was well spoken, loved the Lord with all her heart, served God in spirit and in truth, and the result of the Christian relationship in her very personal life with God in Christ and found that place of absolute trust and serenity given God's unchanging love. I remember quite well Sheldon, Laurie, whom I went into England sometime thereabout, and Sheldon, and Frankie, who is now deceased, and people who showed a great deal of respect to the one who is speaking from this mouth. I am quite elated and very intriguingly fascinated to be standing here to represent within context of the request made to speak in the manner in which I address this body of persons. A life is one that impacts and a number of persons, sometimes on the radio, making or made a contribution on with Pastor Daniel. And of course, very vocal in what she believed. And as a result, many persons were influenced by the tremendous impact she made for her expressions, the Lord Jesus Christ. Unless the wind blow the branches to retrieve the lost sheep. They are still, because there is no energy to make them move. And at the moment, they start to blow energy, hit the branches. They begin to shake, maybe standing there giving life, elegance and beauty of God creation. Such was this woman. When she had to be still, she was still. When she had to move, she would move. And I'm absolutely sure that those who are familiar in retrospect can support what I'm saying here today. I know that she has gone to meet the Lord and made her elect. Paul should. And there is no detach, no detach from the body given upon the void of her life. She had found it in Christ, made her marriage on this community and society and St. Vincent and the Grenadines as a whole. I am sure that her life has been rest, as Jesus said. And I believe what he said in relation to the practice of a Christian faith, by definition, of a character manifested out of the life as the believer who knew the Lord, that she had made an absolute perfect peace with God. Many years ago, may she rest in peace and enjoy all that heaven has to offer, as promising God's words to the Lord Jesus Christ. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go and make ready a place for you. Where I am, there it will be also. Absent from the body, present with the Lord. My sincere and deepest condolences to the family. And I pray that God speaks in comfort. Rest in the love. May God bless you.
First Corinthians 15:50-58. What I'm saying, brothers and sisters, in this flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Nor can corruption inherit incorruption. Listen, I'm telling you a mystery. You will not all fall asleep, but we will all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, as the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we will be changed. For the incorruptible body must be clothed with incorruptibility, and this mortal body must be clothed with immortality. When this corruptible body is clothed with incorruptibility, and this mortal body is clothed with immortality, then the saying that is written will be fulfilled. Death has been swallowed in victory. Where death is your victory? Where death is your sin? The sin of death is sin, and the power of sin is alone. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, it's a fast. A moment on, always excel in the Lord's work, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. Noreen Wilma Douglas was born on 10th July 1936 and grew up in the family car area and attended the Kittens Douglas School. He was blessed with two daughters, Lori and Sola, and one son, Kathy, who is now 6, and one grandchild, Aida. Also amongst those of our relatives who grieve for passing are her nephew and nieces from Grenada. I came to know Ms. Douglas when she was employed at the Public Works and Technical Division at Paypal, also known as Public Scheme, about 35 years ago. Dougie, as she was affectionately called by some of us, and I developed a good working relationship with her tender. And this friendship continued throughout the years. She also developed the time at Public Scheme, close friendship with others such as Eric Moran and Mary Brown, that continued right up to the time of Public Scheme. Dougie was a very expressive and wise person. One who was in the sky of a basic form of kingdom of matters known. I recall that shortly after completing the civil service proficiency bar exam, I was put in charge of the school. Prior to that time, the operation in that unit was a great cause of concern by other members of the staff. Because of the irregularities and the practice. Given my perception of things, I determined that I was going to follow the letter of the law, the application of the financial and stores rule, so as to minimize the irregularities. To my disappointment, I soon realized walk the strength and have a path in the discharge of one's duties was going to exact a certain degree of cost. Things therefore those who profited and desired the continuation of the status quo. As a young civil servant at the time, I became frustrated due to the retaliatory measures that were leveraged against me and wrote my resignation letter. I told her what I had done and then put the letter to read. He then counseled and urged me not to resign, since there were some persons in the department who were supportive of my standard. I'm so glad that someone had challenged those who object and cheated the system. I took the advice and withheld the letter for a few months before finally telling him. The Lord had used Dougie to save me from what I later considered could have been a serious mistake. And in my life. After leaving Fortune Scheme, Dougie migrated to the U.S. somewhere in the region of 1987, where she lived and grew up before returning to an retirement about 2006. In 2001, Dougie took up the family. As Bobby suffered the loss of her son, Tammy, who died in the U.S. in your day. I believe that because of that point, unofficially adopted me as your son. And on one or two occasions, you ask me, Blunt, when am I going to get some black babies? Needless to say, it was a question that I did not have an answer for. Dougie was not only a wise and expressive person, but also a generous soul. I remember that on at least two occasions, while visiting her, that is the medicine, better known as Meadow, coming from the market, has and collected a passive, a packet, which I later understood was his lunch. And that was a regular occurrence. My own experience, no different, was somewhat similar. Every year, for many years, my Christmas gift was always gone. Even in our final lockdown, Dobby insisted that Sherlock picked up my Christmas gift, and according to Sherlock, on or about the 16th of December last year, she was told what to buy for my Christmas. Sherlock bought the gift, but never delivered it until after Christmas. And several reminders from Dobby, whose mind was still as sharp as a razor. Dobby also shared the friendships that she developed from her school days and throughout life growing. In speaking with Sherlock, I was informed that she kept in touch with Miss Ivana Halloween from Saturday. Miss Paulina. Miss Paulina. Woman. Here. Okay, what? Who was to meet? Also, Miss Lewis Murray, whose parent was godmother. She was godmother too, and Jerry Darby, and many others. The friendships and sisterhood of others, such as Mrs. Cordova, Mr. Moss, Santa Dawes, and many others of our brethren and community members and fellow friends and acquaintances greatly valued. On the spiritual side, there was no doubt that Dobby loved the Lord. Since coming home from the U.S., she found joy in fellowshipping with her Lord and brethren here at the New Testament Church in Lomas. And even after her state of health prevented her from attending the church meetings, she found pleasure in the visits that were made and the communion that was administered from time to time by our church family. It would be amiss if I did not state that during the period of her sickness, I cannot recall one time in which I heard her complain. Not one time. She understood quite well that sickness and death was part of our earthly lot because of sin as in Adam. Dougie surpassed her 3 score and 10 by about 15 years. As David the sweet psalmist of Israel, as he heard Solomon his son coming to the end of his days, she was also very conscious that people will soon go the way of all the earth. On the morning of Wednesday, 26th of January, Dougie peacefully took her leave of us. We are assured from the word of God that one day, those of us who know Jesus Christ as our Lord and as our personal Savior will be reunited on that glorious, rapturous resurrection morning. We know and are assured that she is now resting in peace.
Matters. One man's faith allow him to eat every day, but another man whose faith is weak eats only vegetables. The man who eats everything must not look down on him who does not, and the man who does not eat everything must not condemn the man who does. For God has accepted it. Who are you to judge someone else's servant? To his own master he stands or falls. And he will stand, for the Lord is able to make him stand. One man considers one way more sacred than another. Another man considers every day alive. Each one should be fully convinced in his own mind. He who regards one day as special does so to the Lord. He who eats meat eats to the Lord, for he gave thanks to God. And he who abstains does so to the Lord and give thanks to God. For none of us lives to himself alone, and none of us dies to himself alone. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So, whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. And here ends the scripture.
Oh, my goodness, praise me again. Oh, Thank you.
Thank you. so I'm gonna wait. Something mighty sweet about the Lord. Thank you.
as well, and all the other ministers of God in the house.
I know Praise FM was very special to Sister Douglas, very special to her. And so we give her thanks. I want to speak to us on a topic that I took from the text, Exodus chapter 3, verse 13 through 15, and also chapter 5, verse 1 through 2. A very well-known scripture, I believe. It surrounds Moses going to Egypt to carry a message to the children of Israel and also to Pharaoh. Father, thank you for your word. I surrender as your word is right. Let your will be done. I ask for preacher's anointing. And if it be thy will, give me a prophet's anointing, that I may tell forth your word or do what you want me to do. In Jesus' name. Amen. I will not read the text, but I believe that through this discourse that you will perhaps be able to relate to the text. The subject is a question: who is this God? I want to talk to you about Sister Douglas's God. Note, I did not say I want to talk to Sister Douglas. I want to speak to you about who is this God. This question, first of all, when God sent Moses, visited him in the backside of the desert, and God gave him commands, go to the children of Israel and tell them I am going to deliver them. And then go to Pharaoh and say to him, God say, let my people go. Moses was ran for his life. 40 years later, God said, their fathers told them about this God. I pause at this juncture. I often say, we are the ones we blame. My age and all. To be blamed for the reason why our children don't know this God. Because God has given instructions that you must teach them to your children. Tell your children about God. Tell them about the God who you know. But they keep it a secret. Tell them all the time when you didn't have anything to eat. There was nothing in the house. And you pray to your God. And just in the right, or at the right time, send someone. For you know God as a provider. Or perhaps it was the time when you were not well in your body, and the doctor said, I don't know what's wrong with you, and you reached out to God. You got on the phone and you called up the church sister. And most of the time it's a church sister. Because you see, when men pray to pray. Let me give myself just that. Isn't it true? The prayer warriors in the church are women. Thank God for you. But you got on the phone and you called the sister and you say, I want you to go with me before the throne of God. I need Jehovah Rapha, the healer. And he came through for you, but you keep it a secret. material, talk about me. When you sit down in the living room, turn on the TV and talk about me. Don't allow the gadgets to raise them. Tell them about the God whom you love, that they will know. So as soon as the children of Israel heard the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, they knew because they were told. They were told about this God. The question, I have a rather curious mind, by the way. So I try to put myself in the position where, as an Israelite, I am hearing there's 400, in fact, theologians say 430 years that they were in slavery. I'm hearing the God of Abraham have said, I am going to deliver you. So I said, what did that mean to the children of Israel? So I went back and I said, oh, as the God of Abraham, what you would have heard that this God is a promise keeper. Promised Abraham, I'm going to give you children that can't be counted. Not that the stars can't be counted or the sand of the sea cannot be counted. I'm going to give you children. Mind you, the man 100 and his wife 90. But God is faithful. God is faithful. So even those of us who have been grafted in to the body of Christ, by the blood of Christ, we are Abraham's descendants. Sorry to get so theological.
Caused their hearts to become glad.
to remember that Isaac needed a wife. And Abraham sent his servant and said, go and get a wife for my son. God will lead you to speed on. God provided a woman who was a take charge type of woman to complement that laid back man called Isaac. So that even when God spoke to Rebecca while the baby is walking, her womb and said the younger one, the older one will serve the younger one. She remembered. So when Isaac was about to bless Esau, Rebecca said, not so it go. As God said, God knows what or who we need to complement us. Amen. I wish you married her, you stay married, please. Amen. I didn't believe in that. You're not married, give God thanks. But if you're not married, seek God's face for just the right person. Then I remember that there was a famine in the land.
Process. I noticed that the first thing God did was change his name to
Jacob means supplanter, someone who takes what doesn't belong to him. God said, oh, no, let's change now. You're a prince. You're a prince. God took him through a process. He had to face off with another master manipulator by the name of Laban, his uncle. He had to wrestle with God. He had encounters with God over and over again. He had to repent to his brother Esau, whom he had wronged, stole his birthright for gold. The process that Jacob went through involved grief and agony. But God brought him through and made him prince. Who is this God? He is the one that despite our messed up past, despite our life, despite the mistakes that we have made, he will not reject you. He will not reject you because he can take all of that and make you a prince.
Question. Who is this God?
There's so many things I want to do. Why won't God tell me? I don't want that boring life. How you know it's boring? Have you ever surrendered to Jesus? Me and many others can guarantee that if you do, you will, your only regret is going to be, why didn't I do this earlier? Yes, we are giving ourselves. But I know Sister Douglas will rejoice if even one person, especially in your family, who's not saved, but in this service, say, I surrender to Jesus. I surrender to Jesus. Is there one person here this morning or afternoon? Is there one person here this afternoon? Who said, Pastor, would you pray for me? I have tried. I have run. I felt many times the urge, that pressing to give my heart to the Lord, and I keep running. But tell you, I'm not going to run anymore. I don't know how it's going to work out, but I'm going to trust God. I'm going to trust God. Or would you keep on saying, who is this God? Who gave you the authority to tell me what to do? Is there one person? I have on my glasses so I can see what's going to happen. Is there one person? Even as we leave this place, I pray that the Spirit of God will continue to impress upon you. That He will give you no rest until you say yes to Jesus. Even if you didn't do it here right now, you don't have to be in a church, do you? Wherever you are, you can surrender your life to Him. That's my encouragement for you. Can I ask the family members to stand, please, as we pray for you? Please join with me as we pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we are grateful for the life of Sister Douglas. We thank you, Lord, and right to the very end, you have been with her. And standing before you, our generations, those bonded by blood and otherwise. Oh God, their hearts might be heavy, their hearts might be grieving at this moment. So I pray, Lord, that you would comfort them. I pray, oh God, by your Spirit, that you would strengthen them. That God, that they know they can, let them know that you are there for them. That even though they are going through what might be like the valley of the shadow of death, Lord, that they can trust you, that they can depend on you, that you will be there, and that you are there with them. I ask you to strengthen them. I pray that even in this very sad occasion, God, that out of this will come much good. That the family will be knitted together. That the family will be bonded even stronger. I pray, Lord, that you would put the right persons in their lives with the right word at the right time. Keep evil from them. Keep negativity from them. Let the words that they hear be like seasoning. Let the words that they hear be those that will uplift their spirits. In the name of Jesus, I commit them into your hands, Lord, for your glory. In Jesus' name. again and again. Thank you so much. According to our program, we are going to have a reception on him when we all get to heaven. I usually have a little problem with that song because only those who surrender their lives to Jesus will be getting to heaven. But I see him. So, we sing that when we all get to heaven. We can ask the Lord, when you're on the street, please keep on one side of the road. Don't block up the entire road. That's the main road. And you know the amount of trucks that come up and down this place, alright? So, one side of the road, right up to the cemetery. Amen? God bless you. And do enjoy the balance of your day. God bless.
Shut up.
Oh,
Blessings.
Well done, well done.
Thank you.
Hey, you see when you pass?
Blessings, blessings. Hello. Oh, wait, everybody are coming. If you're dead. Everybody leave any dead up here?
I thought it came down.
Am I wrong? How are you?
I take candy, nobody, sister. I have to take. It's on my top. I just don't want to say.
Well, let me get that girl to keep on. I'm talking to one more. Hey, no.
Hello. Hello? Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
so.
That program? That is.
Take it there and go down
to there. And the come
up side and come there. Did it rest over here? And the rest on there?
Nah,
over there. Saka over there.
Huh?
But then go over there.
Yeah. What is? Guide the guy them. Guide the man them. Boy, so
my turn could have chopped down right here.
Yeah, me tell him put it in there. Me tell Mark to put it in there.
Same thing. Why? Then I come now with it. No. Shaka, you still have to reach this, so you know. Shaka, you still have to go there for catch your backs for any man of them too, you know. You have to go. Yeah, but you can't matter with them this, so you have to go there, you walk, you do too. No, but you have to catch over. They're supposed to box the chap out of the hand. I don't go blame the funeral home. He man have to do the work. I have to understand that too.
Of a believer, and even in its length, we realize the fleetingness of life. While we sorrow at Sister Noreen's absence, we know that she is rejoicing with the saints in the presence of God. The believer's death is only a transition into eternal life with Christ Jesus. Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you for today. Lord, we thank you for the life of Sister Noreen Douglas. And even now as we reflect, oh God, we ask, oh God, that our life will be an example to us. And as we mourn, oh God, continue to comfort those who are mourning. In Jesus' name, amen.
Darren, hold this a minute. Hold it.
Now, remembering that God created the first human, Adam, from the dust of the earth, return the body of our sister to the ground of this planet. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. We listen to the words spoken of the Apostle John. Right, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. They will rest from their labors, for their deeds will follow them. And our band will accompany us as we sing this first Tim, we have an anchor and they'll follow the program as it.
Thank you.
dying.